Of all the fearsome, enormous, and weaponry-equipped animals that roam the vast lands of Africa, hippos are famously known to be one of the most dangerous animals on the continent. The massive creatures somewhat resemble pigs or even cows, but despite their mostly herbivorous diet, they are known to be very aggressive, even easily defeating full-grown crocodiles in territorial disputes. This is all the more reason why the famous Christmas song, I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas, which was performed by 10-year-old Gayla Peavy, is meant to be so quirky and ludicrous. In fact, the silly novelty song was even used in a campaign, the Gayla Peavy Hippo Fund, to help the Oklahoma City Zoo acquire one of the semi-aquatic behemoths. Peavy was finally granted her request for a hippo Christmas gift, and she, of course, subsequently donated it to the zoo. It turns out that she wasn't fully prepared for such a unique pet. However, she was present when the zoo received a rare pygmy hippopotamus in 2017 at 73 years old. The original hippo lived for nearly 50 years. We know people own all kinds of exotic animals, but surely no one has kept such an unsuitable species as a pet outside of a zoo, right? Well, if you thought that hippos are never kept as pets, you'd be wrong. In case you were wondering, it is technically legal to own a hippo in some areas of the United States, but it is unlikely occurring privately in North America. President Calvin Coolidge, an owner of many exotic pets, was gifted a pygmy hippo named Billy, who spent most of his life in the National Zoo, and would become one of the founders of the American zoological population of pygmy hippos, having sired 23 calves. It might not come as a shock that hippos are not commonly owned pets. The Colombian drug lord Pablo Escobar famously had them shipped to his private zoo in the 1970s, but when he died in 1993, his animals escaped into the local rivers and continue to be a problem to this day. Of course, Escobar wouldn't be considered to be a pet owner by most, as the animals were not directly taken care of by him, nor did he directly interact with the dangerous creatures. This was certainly not the case for Maurice Ells, who claims to have rescued a 5-month-old baby hippo he named Humphrey in 2005, and kept the animal as a pet on his 400-acre farm in the Free State province. Not only did he care for and raise Humphrey, he rode on the animal's back, swam with him, and helped him brush his massive teeth as a full-grown adult. This is all despite Humphrey's concerning behavior of breaking out of his enclosure and wandering the adjacent golf club. He even killed several cattle and attacked Els' nephew. They think you can only have a relationship with dogs, cats, and domestic animals, Els said. He has said that the animal was like a human son to him, and there was no denying the two had a connection. But sadly, the reputation of the hippo would come to reveal itself to his devoted owner in a devastating way. On November 2011, Humphrey attacked his owner, biting him to death and leaving him submerged in the river that he was originally rescued from. Sadly, while many animals can be extremely friendly and tame, all it takes is one incident, especially with an animal Humphrey's size, to cause an irreversible fatality. Hippos, regardless of how they've been raised, are not immune to aggressive outbursts, and this rings true of any animal, domesticated or not. However, Humphrey, being a male, was especially prone to territoriality, just like domestic cattle. What about female hippos? Jessica is a famous 21-year-old hippo living carefree in South Africa after her rescue from a flood in 2000, and she is still going strong. She's been featured in documentaries and even the Oprah Winfrey Show. Her owners, Tony and Shirley Joubert, feed her veggies and 20 liters of rooibos tea a day. Jessica roams freely on the Game Ranger's property, which is now a popular tourist attraction called Jessica's Place, and she still interacts with wild hippos. However, she also interacts with guests who pet and feed her. Then she'll even enter the Joubert's home and sleep with their 5 English Bull Terriers. However, there is another hippo named Richie, another rescue that was added to the attraction in 2012. This male hippo has been accused of viciously attacking 2 visitors, who left a scathing 1-star review on TripAdvisor as a result. One of the victims described the attack as her being thrown around like a rag jackdaw, and with both of her legs in his mouth, he began to drag her into the water until her cousin intervened. The animal then mauled her cousin, but thankfully, both of them survived. The hippo's owners denied that the offending hippo was Jessica or Richie, insisting that they were both home at the time of the incident, and that the attacking animal was a wild hippo. Given what happened to Humphrey's owner, however, one cannot be too confident that such an animal could not behave in a similarly aggressive fashion. It's also questionable that the two women would have been able to ward off an attack from an unsocialized wild angry hippo, which is an animal that strikes fear in the hearts of fully grown crocodiles. Regardless, Humphrey, Jessica, and Richie have shown us that hippos can be just as loving as mainstream pets. However, their enormous size obviously makes them inherently dangerous. However, this is no different from a dangerous bull, which is still a domesticated animal. Hippos might seem like an animal that would be impossible to have an interactive relationship with, but this might merely be due to the fact that few have tried. So while a hippo might not make the best Christmas gift, it's clear they have the capacity to be just as tame as other animals, and their lack of usefulness to humans might be the main reason they've never been propagated to the extent of other animals that eventually became domesticated.